words of wisdom exist that open our minds to hidden truths. And every day, we lose more of them.
So imagine the libraries of America being destroyed one by one. This is what happened in Tibet in 1959. The most important thing that the Tibetan contribution has given us is the extraordinary canon of the original Buddha's words. And hence now we have copies of this that are now being digitized by us, ACIP, for the preservation for future generations.
Before 1300 AD, Buddha's teachings had never been assembled as one collection, until a Tibetan monk and scholar named Bhutan Rinchen Drup undertook a 20-year commitment to compile and hand-print three copies of a 112-volume collection that came to be known as the Kangyur, which means translations of the pronouncements of the Buddha. Each copy contains more than 1,000 teachings or sutras of the Buddha. Woodblocks were carved from the handwritten manuscripts and used to mass produce the Kangyur. These copies spread throughout Tibet and empowered a renaissance of spiritual wisdom that produced some of the greatest Buddhist commentaries the world has ever known, such as the works of Jay Tsongkhapa, founder of the lineage of the Dalai Lamas. But the woodblock carvings of the original Kangyur had mistakes, and two of the three original handwritten manuscripts were lost to the ravages of time and war. The third and only remaining original, known as the Tempama Kangyur, was protected in the Potala Palace in Lhasa until the 1650s. When the first Panchen Lama, Losong Chukyi Gelsen, in an act of incredible generosity, gave the last remaining original to a Mongolian monk named Zanabazar, who had miraculously healed him of a fatal illness through devout prayers and offerings. Traveling over 2,500 miles on horseback before bringing the irreplaceable collection back to his homeland, Zanabazar, a Tsongkhapa-like figure, established an authentic Buddhist lineage in Mongolia. He created a visionary legacy of spiritual expression through his art, poetry, and students. The Tempama Kangyur was housed at the library of the Mongolian kings from the 1650s until the 1930s, when Buddhism was destroyed in Mongolia. Over 700 monasteries were destroyed. 30,000 monks were killed. The rest were forced to disrobe, and hundreds of libraries were burned. The King's Library, now called the National Mongolian Library, remains the repository of the Tempama Kangyur to this day. But invasions, war, and the violent forces of time have turned this sanctuary into a tenuous refuge. And yet this is possibly the largest collection of Buddhist literature in the world. Its manuscripts contain some of the most powerful and profound realizations known to human thought. Great lamas teach from them directly. Scholars translate them to decipher their secrets. And now the West has the opportunity to continue this authentic spiritual tradition.
This Kangyur is going to Mongolia. Mongolian Buddhist religion is prospering. Rebirth. Regain, yeah? Now in the ACIP shooting, scanning, the whole nation is looking this Tengu, yeah? The American Buddhism proceeding, I think so.
The manuscripts contain immense power, yet they are as fragile as they are priceless.
The Asian Classics Input Project has recently gained permission to scan a one-of-a-kind, completely uncorrupted edition of the Tempama Kangyur. This will enable the West for the first time to see this remarkable text in its purest form. So far, we have cataloged over 35,000 titles in the collection. We estimate there are over 600,000 titles left to do. The other aspect is scanning and digitizing countless tens of thousands of new texts that we estimate we'll find there. It'll take us over 20 years. These texts have traveled over 2,000 years to get to the National Mongolian Library. And now, for the first time, they're being passed on to us, to everyone, uncorrupted, authentic. If we do not save this wisdom now, a time will come when it will be lost forever.